Thank you, Tony Axierito. Thank you. Tony, whatever you had in the morning, you should have it all the time. Because you're very excited, and I love it when people say nice things about Hyderabad. Amit, thank you for having us. Michael, thank you for joining us, for coming back to India. Ranjit Reddy Garu, Mahesh, thank you for showing us the place. And thank you for making sure that all of your employees wear masks only today. I know it. They know it. Evaru mask esukovatledu kada. The mask kosam iroju esukunnattu Mahesh chesaru. Thank you, Mahesh, for that. Shakti, my colleague, from my department, director of life sciences, and to all the employees and the family of Thermo Fisher, thank you for having us. And to the friends from media, I thank you all for joining us. I keep saying this, and I will say it again. Hyderabad and Telangana is that exciting place where biology meets technology, life sciences meets data sciences, and the north of India meets the south of India. That's the beauty of Hyderabad. We are a melting pot. And this exciting confluence point, this exciting point of intersection, is what makes us special. Because in today's world, you know, it's not just pure biology or pure IT. It's a convergence of both, which is actually on the anvil of conquering newer frontiers and, you know, disrupting the way we work and the way we think. Extremely delighted that, this new center of Thermo Fisher Scientific, the engineering center, is being inaugurated today. Happy to note that this is a world-class research and development center being set up with an annual planned R&D investment of over $15 million and will employ over 450 diversely talented engineers and vendor partners. Spread across 42,000 square feet, I am told that this facility specifically is curated to support new product development and product optimization of laboratory equipments for laboratory and analytical solutions for Thermo Fisher's global sites. I've also been told that Thermo Fisher Scientific invests more than $1.4 billion annually in R&D and boasts of an exceptional R&D across more than 100 locations. And I'm delighted that Thermo Fisher has chosen Hyderabad for its India Engineering Center, which reinforces Hyderabad's research and innovation prowess. In addition to the life sciences and pharmaceuticals, I have also been informed that IEC will focus on product development, on analytical instruments for soil and water analysis, laboratory equipment, web gauging, instruments for lithium-ion battery production, etc. I had the pleasure of visiting Thermo Fisher's headquarters in Boston just about a month ago, and I met with Ms. Julie Devane, the Vice President of Global Operations, Life Sciences and Laboratory Products Group, and Mr. Ty Mortensen, who is the Vice President of Strategic Operations. I must say, the visit actually took me back to my graduate days. I am a biologist by training, and Thermo Fisher is a name you will definitely come across in every laboratory. For those of you who don't know, I actually have a master's degree in biotechnology. I don't know if any of you actually are from biotech background, but to those of you, that was, of course, much, much older now. That was like almost 30 years ago. I'm happy to note that this center in Hyderabad will support Thermo Fisher's scientific R&D and global operations from Hyderabad, and wish that the company only grows from strength to strength. Hyderabad has been consolidating its position as one of the most dynamic scientific centers in Asia and globally. Hyderabad is also known as a cradle of life sciences research and development, a great hub for talent in various disciplines, and a catalyst of intersection, as I put it, of life sciences and technology. We have a number of R&D institutions par global excellence, such as the Indian Drug and Pharmaceuticals Limited, IDPL, International Crop Research Institute for Semi-Arid Tropics, the ICRISAT, Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology, Indian Institute of Chemical Technology, among many others. I am delighted that a recent study conducted by FDI Benchmark points out that Hyderabad is the world's most competitive location for life sciences R&D functions when compared with life sciences clusters across the world. We have consistently tried to retain this momentum by establishing sector-specific industrial clusters such as Genome Valley, which has become a major innovation and life sciences cluster in Asia. I would also emphasize that Hyderabad not just offers competitive industrial infrastructure, but a comprehensive ecosystem for life sciences research and development, including plug-and-play labs, shared scientific infrastructure and testing facilities, access to CROs, and highly skilled talent pool, and much, much more. I would also like to highlight that Hyderabad is one of the most preferred locations to set up global capability centers, GCCs in general, and in life sciences, healthcare in particular. Marquee players such as Novartis, Medtronic, Providence, Nectar Therapeutics, Intel, Micron, OnePlus, Oppo, AMD, among many others, have set up their global capability centers in Hyderabad. And I'm extremely glad that today we could add another one from a prestigious and highly research-focused organization like Thermo Fisher Scientific. I would like to reiterate that the state of Telangana has systemically curated its Vision 2030 for life sciences sector to achieve $100 billion US ecosystem by focusing on innovation-driven and tech-enabled growth. The life sciences industry and the state of Telangana have had a symbiotic relationship over the years, paving the road for growth for one another. I assure that the government of Telangana will continue to work hand in hand with the industry to further strengthen the high-quality infrastructure and favorable policies to become a preeminent innovation destination globally. Once again, would like to congratulate the team of Thermo Fisher Scientific for the facility inauguration, and I've said this to Julie when I met her in Boston. I'll say this to you guys as well. Hyderabad has a way to surprise all of us. You know, in fact, when organizations come into the city or our state and have set targets for themselves, you know, we will be at a certain level, at a certain number, by a certain date, typically they tend to get surprised that they surpass them much ahead of time. So I hope Thermo Fisher also will actually invest more, will think of manufacturing from Telangana, and will continue to grow from strength to strength. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Rama Rao Garu. May I now...